Okay, Keir, so your win rate here at Melksham Town is pretty good under the lights, and it held up tonight, a 3-1 win against Salisbury in the Premier Shield. I don't think many of us thought we were going to get anything from this evening. Summarise that one for me.
Yeah, like you said, I've got a good relationship with this ground at Melksham. It's almost like old days coming back here, lots of friendly faces. Had a really good relationship with all the supporters at Melksham when I was here, and it was a Gary Higdon goal under the lights midweek. And yeah, like you said, we don't lose many under the lights when I was Melksham manager, and glad to keep that up for Corsham tonight in a really, really enjoyable game. I need some time to reflect on the whole game because there'll be loads of things that I've missed. But I thought thoroughly deserved winners. Worked ridiculously hard, like another level we went tonight, and going 2-0 at half time, and I knew that they would have a reaction. I warned the boys about it coming back out. They got one back very early, and you're thinking, you know, it's gonna continue to rain, but we weathered the storm, and then we picked them off on the counter attack to make it 3-1, and then just saw the game out, as like you've seen us do many a times when we go ahead. We're very, very good at managing the games, and it was a really famous win for Corsham, and one that I really, really enjoyed. Had great support, not sure on total numbers, but you could hear the roar and the raptures walking off, and in the support that we had, and it, you know, it goes a long way, and it means a lot to the boys in there to get to a final. I know there might have been talk of it being at the county ground, you know, Swindon's home ground, so it'd be a really nice day out for Corsham. So you know, we haven't won anything as such, you know, not won a cup yet, but you know, to progress to the final with the teams that are in here, you know, Salisbury City, Chippenham Town, you know, just to name a couple. And Melksham as well, who are in it. So, you know, we've deserved our place in the final, and now we can just go and enjoy the day, enjoy the occasion, and a brilliant way to finish the season. You know, I think we've just come up short, left ourselves too much to do in the league. So this was all our eggs in one basket, so to speak, in the semi-final. Went full strength as possible. Obviously, had Coop suspended, but the boys went through it for each other, for me, for the badge tonight, and couldn't be prouder of that performance. So, yeah, a really nice day to look forward to now.
In the league, sometimes when we've had a 1-2 goal lead, we've let goals in late on in the game. Going in at half time against a team like Salisbury, what was the game plan going into the second half?
To try and stay on the front foot as much as possible, but it happens with the game, and that Salisbury is so good with possession, they're going to get chances, and you know, we had to have a little bit of luck with that. But I think they might have underestimated us first half. To say that we caught them on the hop was probably an understatement. You know, when we come in 2-0 up, and then I warned the boys at halftime it was going to be a completely different game second half, and they really, really stepped it up, deservedly got a goal back. They peppered us for about 10 minutes at the start of the first half. And then we weathered that storm, as I spoke about, and picked them off at a really, really good time. But, you know, it's one of those things where, you know, the longer the game was going on, at 3-1, you know, you're looking at your watch, you're ticking it off, and you're just hoping that we can stay strong. And we have done. I think we're very good at seeing games out. And we've had a little bit of bad luck recently, obviously, in the Westbury game. The last-minute equaliser to Malvern, that you mentioned there. So I was just delighted, yeah, to see the clock run down without too much fuss. So, yeah, really enjoyable night. Probably one of my favourites. Up there with the FA Cup win on my very first game for Corsham, we won on penalties. This one's probably right up there, and had that same, you know, feeling of euphoria after, like now everyone's buzzing in there, singing and dancing. And I know it's obviously a bigger occasion to Corsham than it is to Salisbury, but take nothing away from the boys in there. You know, they deserved it, and we'll look forward to that final now.
Getting to this point, a lot of development players stepped up against Bradford to get us to this point. How difficult was it putting together the starting 11 tonight?
Yeah, and I spoke to a lot of the development boys. I wanted them to be involved. Emilio, Joe King, Jamie Cunning, to name a few. Obviously, boys that have been dual registered, my brother Ryan and Jim, who's now gone back to Warminster, have all been involved tonight. You know, they've been invited up and to be part of the match day squad, and they'll get the same treatment for cup final day. So I think it's important that you speak to people properly. And I don't think there's any issues there. I think they know that, you know, the boys that play week in, week out will start ahead of those. At that point of the quarterfinals, we had a really, really busy schedule, and it was important that I freshened it up. They done the club proud that night, and then they deservedly been involved tonight, and the same thing will happen wherever that cup final is, to make sure that it's a full day out for the whole club. You know, if you think of some of the performances tonight, Asa and Brandon, to mention high up in the list, they were absolutely phenomenal at Brandon's old club. Might have nicked the goal off of Naif, but I thought him and Asa was difficult to separate the two. They were absolutely tremendous, as were the whole team. But it's a squad game over the course of the season. We've got Westbury Saturday in the Hellenic Cup, and then we'll have to see what happens with the progression of that competition. We obviously got Bradford in the league and Wootton Bassett still, but obviously this was the main priority for us now, to get to a cup final in our first season at this level, to build on last season promotion, more success for myself and the management team, and most importantly for the players. But I think it's just great for even people connected with the club, you know, the chairman, the committee, yourself, people that put tireless work in, to have a day out like that, brilliant. You think of like people like Doug Perry, who was really emotional when we walked off the pitch, you know, to see us go to a cup final for Corsham. It means the world to them, and it does to me. So I was absolutely delighted with that, and to bring that day out to the whole club is something I'm really proud of.